Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, DaBoss, for another video today. Today, guys, I am joined by Master of the TDS.
Hello!
And today, guys, we have a very special podcast for you. This is pretty much a game changer for all you Yu-Gi-Oh! Fans out there. Me and TDS have
come... No pun intended.
Yes, no pun intended. Maybe. Anyway, so... We have come together to talk to you guys about a big thing happening in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community. TDS was actually the one to tell me about this in the first place, which I think is amazing and sort of, you know, it's kind of hard to describe when you think about it, depending on who you are. But TDS, explain to everyone what the news is, since you were the one that made me aware of this, so.
All right. Well, basically, I don't know when this is going into effect exactly. I do know this was released... February 17th, so it was not that long ago. There are going to be new rules in Yu-Gi-Oh! Now, they've released not that long ago that there was going to be another continuation, like another Yu-Gi-Oh! Like animated series, you know, kind of thing. And they were going to be playing card games on hoverboards, which for some reason makes more sense than card games on motorcycles. I don't know.
Door runners?
We were all thinking, okay, they're going to have to add some new mechanic. We were thinking, like, a new extra deck monster or do something. No, they did something with the extra deck, but it wasn't what we expected. They're new, introducing the Link Summon. Now, what the Link Summon is, they also changed the field so that, first off, the pendulum scales are no longer separate from the board. They're in the back row now. And if you use pendulums, you can play them as, like, it's in Magic and Trap card slots, but you only have three left. So it's basically balancing pendulums more. And now there's also a new zone called the Extra Monster Zone. And from now on, basically what we have here is extra deck monsters like Fusion, Synchro, Xyz, and Link cannot be summoned to the main monster zone. Meaning before, when you were able to spam tons of Xyz or Synchro, whatever you, or Fusion, to the normal monster zone, that does not happen anymore. Now you can only summon them to the extra monster zone. Now, there's only one extra monster zone per player. So probably thinking that makes no sense. How are you going to use that? Well, that's where the Link summon comes. What the Link summon is a card. It's a blue card. I don't know why they forgot about rituals for some reason that already had blue backing. They could have used red for this one. Just saying. But basically, your regular cards, they're Link. Like this, like for example, the one that's called Decode Talker is a Link 3. It's going to be the main monster of the new protagonist of the show. And basically, on the card, there's two arrows pointing to other directions, and two of them are lit up. And basically, when you activate a Link monster, you have to summon it in a strange way. It's still really confusing, but basically, where the arrows are pointing, the spaces they'll point to, the normal monster zones they're pointing to, become unlocked, and you are then allowed to summon extra deck monsters there. Basically meaning that every single deck that you've played so far right from now, you're pretty much going to be starting from scratch, because unless you want to play only one extra deck monster, which you can do, I guess, if you're that interested, but you need, basically what Konami has done is basically, instead of with the other mechanics where you could have a choice whether to do it or not, Konami has basically made it that you no longer have one, and you need to play these Link monsters in order to access your extra deck at all anymore, which basically changes the game like crazy in both good ways and both bad ways. I mean, it does slow the game down, and it makes it a lot more gives smaller decks a lot more of a chance. But at the same time, was it really fair of Konami to force this on us? Was it really fair to change it so drastically? And I've seen people going, "Rip Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm selling all my cards!" And I'm like, I'm just kind of intrigued. I don't know about you, boss, but I find it intriguing.
Well, I think I'm going to be switching to Bakugan now, in case anyone's wondering. So, yeah, great job, Konami. No, I'm just kidding. No, Bakugan's for nerds. Anyway, so, yeah, no.
I have some Bakugan, I'll have you know.
You're proving my point very nicely, TDS.
Yeah, I know.
No, but seriously, though, guys, that is the current situation with Konami and the new news surrounding with Yu-Gi-Oh! As far as my thoughts go, like, initial thoughts anyway, because, you know, hasn't exactly happened majorly yet. As far as my thoughts go, I mean, on one hand, you got to think about it this way. Konami, maybe they were listening to everyone's opinions on saying, you know, some things about Yu-Gi-Oh! And the game itself need to be changed. You know, people wanting major changes done and Konami to actually do something about it. Because, as we've even talked about before, they don't exactly have the best track record with responding to the fans and the community. So, you know...
No track record.
Exactly. On one hand... on one hand, you have... You know, it does give smaller decks a chance, just like TDS said. It gives them more of an opportunity to be able to maybe utilize new things with the extra deck, taking advantage of, you know, the link and whatnot. However, though, even considering that in mind, you have to wonder, Konami, as far as I know, TDS, they didn't give anyone advance warning about this new community, did they?
They just dropped it on us like a big bomb.
Okay, so the thing that gets me, like, wondering and thinking in my mind is Konami didn't ask or tell anyone in the community about, you know, the changes that would be coming to the card game. And something like this, considering how, you know, the extra deck is obviously a big part of the game and it utilizes a lot of strategy, it's a really big deal in the community. The thing with me is Konami didn't tell anyone about it beforehand, which means no one had time to prepare for any changes that could possibly be coming, good or bad. So, I mean, again, smaller deck, you could work out better. But, like, a major deck, someone who's been working, let's say, like, a year on a deck, and they have this whole strategy utilized on, like, summoning Blue Eyes White Dragon, or Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon, your strategy is...
Or Neo Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon.
Exactly. Your cards are basically as useful as Yugi's Exodia cards being thrown into the ocean. So, yeah. Another thing that makes me wonder about Konami is it really a good decision about what they made? I mean, a lot of people, you know, they might be in support of it because, you know, it works to their advantage if they're not as big or they don't have as much strategy with their decks. But the people that are like old school, old time fans who have built these amazing decks, now they essentially kind of get screwed over in what they're doing with playing the card game itself. And the thing that majorly bothers me, in addition to a lot of the negativity going on and the fact that they didn't say anything, is, like we said, mentioned earlier, a lot of people are saying now that they just want to quit the card game because, you know, it's essentially useless. Which brings me to a point saying, could this new rule be better? Yes. Could it be potentially bad? Maybe. We don't know yet because it hasn't really happened that much. It's been announced, but we don't know what impact it'll have. But please, people. I mean, I love Yu-Gi-Oh! TDS loves Yu-Gi-Oh! There's a lot of people out there who love the game. Don't say you're going to quit or move on to Bakugan or Pokemon or forbid you ever go into Beyblade or something. Just because of this new rule. I mean, you don't know what it's going to do yet. It might not sound appealing, and admittedly, there are maybe some problems with it. But don't say that you're going to quit the card game and give up something that you love to do just because of one rule, no matter how major or minor it could be. I mean, give it a chance, and if you don't like it, doesn't mean you should just pack it and quit.
I agree, and you know, in a way, I can kind of see through Konami's smokescreen they're trying to put up here. I mean, this could be potentially useful, and it could be potentially harmful. It depends on how they go about it, but I think it doesn't matter which way they go about it, because I think that deep down, Konami doesn't care. I think Konami, this is all a marketing strategy, because anybody who plays Yu-Gi-Oh!, no matter what deck you have, no matter what, except for maybe Monarchs, because Monarchs don't run extra deck, but aside from Monarch, you used an extra deck, and now they're saying, oh, guess what? You can't anymore, unless you only want to have one extra deck monster, which would be infinitely sucky and not work. But basically what they're saying now is that, oh, guess what? You have to buy these new cards, which is kind of what they've been doing all along, making like the most powerful decks, people buy it. And it just seems like this to me is just like another marketing campaign, only this one's like forcing us to buy it. Now, I find it interesting that the boss also found it interesting that I posted a video 2 days before this was announced mentioning the game was changing.
Here's an informant in Konami, guys.
Whether or not I knew anything, or maybe I have some inside information, I don't know, maybe I do, maybe I don't. Regardless, this isn't... Maybe I was referring to this, maybe I wasn't, but regardless... It's good in a sense because it's kind of like, this is a bad example, but like, you know, the biblical flood of Noah. You know, you ever heard of this, DeMoss?
Yeah, I have actually. I've read about it many times.
Where God destroyed the world and then remade it again.
Yeah, after in Noah, and he took.
Imagine Konami is God here. And what Konami has just done is flooded the entire meta with all the stuff, and then they just said, you know what, we're going to drown everybody, and they just drown everybody. We're all in the same boat now. It doesn't matter what deck you play or how powerful you are. When these new rules come into effect, we're all going to be on the same level. No one's going to know better than somebody else. Only Konami will. So I think, is this potentially a way of unifying the community? And it can be. Do I think it's possible? Yes. Do I think it's going to happen? I hope so. But, I mean, you know, past experiences show that that doesn't really happen. And for the people who are freaking out and going, oh my god, rip Yu-Gi-Oh, I'm leaving, I'm going to sell my cards, take a deep breath, relax. Everybody said the exact same thing when they announced archetypes and when they announced, you know, synchros and when they announced Xyz and when they announced pendulums, and everybody still stayed. And maybe some people did leave. And if that's their choice, that's their choice. But if this is a game you love, you adapt to it. Now, do I think Konami was right in doing this? No, of course not. I think they were really dropped this on us really rather quickly, and I think that they should have at least, you know, like, mentioned something. Oh, we're going to have a new mechanic that's going to change the game. They didn't really mention that. They did mention they're going to have a new mechanic, but they didn't mention it was going to be this drastically changing. I do think this could help. It could balance things. But at the same time, is it going to balance things and keep them balanced, or is it going to have it go over to one side or the other? And that's what I'm curious about, because for as all as I can see, this is just an elaborate marketing scam by Konami, because that's what all they care about is money. And this is now forcing everybody to buy the new cards, but it could be a good thing. I mean, that's just my opinion. Am I personally going to play? I'll try it out. But, like, I'm not investing as much of an effort as I would have before, because, like, this could be the new format for a format, and Konami could decide, you know, we don't like this anymore, and just change it. That's what I'm saying. They have, like, so much power, and they could literally, now that they know this, if they know this works, they can do it again.
Yeah, and you know what? I agree with what you're saying here. The thing is, there are, like, two things that I wanted to address about, like, what you were saying. And I agree with, you know, Konami, they've proven before, and again, we've talked about this, like, many times in the past, about Konami, you know, just using things as marketing campaigns and ploys. And for all we know, this could be just a thing to get people to buy a whole bunch of cards, and then once they rake in the cash, as they say, they could make another big rule change and then be like, oh, by the way, we're changing something else. You can't have 4-star monsters in your deck. You can only have 3-star monsters. And they come out with these different packs exclusively for 3-star monsters. It could just be a whole thing of that. I mean, I would like to believe, as a fan, that Konami cares and they're trying their best to improve the game and maybe, you know, as TDS said, unify the community, maybe make everyone come together, as, you know, everyone will be the same now. And, you know, maybe make the game, you know, great like it was. And I'm not saying the game's not great, but let's face it, guys. The community hasn't exactly been at its greatest recently. But maybe this could be a way to do it. However, it is at the same time, it could be just another marketing ploy. Or it could be something for Konami to, you know, just rake in the money. And, you know, then drop another bomb on us with something else major. Then everyone just starts freaking out again. And the process will just repeat itself. And, you know, that's not exactly a good way of improving the game and or bringing everyone together. Another thing that I was sort of like thinking about a little bit was the whole thing of people saying that they were going to quit the game and maybe the possibility of making the community better. Aside from the whole marketing ploy possibility with Konami, which is a possibility just due to their past track records and everything, I honestly hope that in some way, regardless of what happens with this rule, because again, it could be good, could be bad, you know, people view it differently, different perspectives. I honestly hope that this is going to be used as something to unify everyone, because, you know, we would all be in the same boat. I mean, even me, I mean, my deck right now, when this new rule goes into effect, I'm going to have to redo it in some way. I'm going to have to, because I have tournaments that I do with my friends. I'm in a few tournaments here in my town. And, you know, I love the game, but, I mean, I'm not going to freak out over it and be like, oh, well, I'm done with the game. I'm going to go burn all my cards. I'm going to throw them in the ocean, RIP Exodia.
At least sell at least sell them so they're worth something.
No, I'm not going to sell my cards either. I have some really valuable cards.
What I'm saying is, if it's versus throwing your Exodia cards off a boat or selling them, please sell them.
Please, yes. If it comes down to it, if you're actually serious on giving up the game, sell the cards instead of just destroying them so you get some money.
Don't do a Weevil. Don't pull a Weevil.
No,
we don't like Weevils.
Do not pull a Weevil on it, and you know, get that whole 99 cents you can out of your Yu-Gi-Oh cards, guys. It's better than nothing. No, but seriously. you know, again, I honestly hope, though, even with the possibility that people will quit, and you know what, that's your guys' choice, or that's anyone's choice. If you guys want to give it up, and you want to go, you know, trade your Yu-Gi-Oh cards in for some Bakugan, or don't know why anyone would, Beyblades, but, you know, this could be used to unify everyone together. The community can come together on the same level. You know, embrace the new rule. You may not like it, but if you really still want to keep playing the game, embrace it, adjust to it, adapt. There have been many changes before, and if you've adapted to those, you can adapt to these too. And, you know, maybe make the community even better, you know, or better than what it has been anyway. You know, just come together. It's not the end of the game. It's not even close to the end of the world. It's just a way, even with whatever Konami's real motive is for doing this, it could potentially be a way to bring everyone together, and I think that's something you guys should just keep in mind and move forward.
Yeah, and also, you have to realize, guys, that there's going to be a ton of people who, yes, there's always new people in the game, but this may attract either new people, and even people who are not new will not know what to do here. If somebody knows how to play these cards better, please don't judge the other person badly for not knowing. This is a brand new mechanic that nobody knows about right now. I am sure someone will figure it out and know better than anybody else, and then they'll play and they'll be like, oh, you don't know how to use links. You're a noob. No. Give them a break. It's different when somebody comes into the game and doesn't read their cards and just uses them willy-nilly. I get that. But this is a completely new thing. You gotta cut them some slack, guys. Come on, we're a community here. Even if it's a bad community, just try to be nice. Come on. You know, everybody's going to be in the same boat now. Nobody knows what to do. Help out. You know, it can't hurt. And at the end of the day, you may be making someone a better player because of it.
Or if not, you just want to sabotage them. Just throw their Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon into the ocean. You know, it can float.
Rip Blue Eyes.
Yeah, rip Blue Eyes.
Or you could do a Kaiba and just find the fourth Blue Eyes and rip it in half.
Or, you know, you could just summon Exodia and put Kaiba in a coma. You could do that, too.
Obliterate!
Exodia, obliterate! Yeah.
Or you could pull a Kaiba and just screw the rules and do whatever you want.
I think that's with, like, every single duel Kaiba has been in. He's found some way to either bend the rules or he's just doing it for, like, the wrong motivation. Or what you could do if you really...
First duel with Yugi, he one turn goes, I summon three Blue Eyes White Dragons.
See, I don't even know how he pulled that off, even with,
dude,
like, the...
Dude, you need to tribute.
Exactly. Even with the standard rules at the beginning of the game, when the TV show was coming out. You know what, at that point, Kaiba was like a smug piece of work, and no one, I don't think, liked him in the beginning. So I'm really glad...
Because nobody knew the rules until Pegasus told us them, I think Kaiba just made up his own rules.
Pegasus was still cheating. I mean, come on. The Millennium Eye.
Except for Exodia. Exodia can beat me, but anything else dies.
Exactly. And you know what? Pegasus had the Millennium Eye, so he was cheating anyway.
Yeah, I guess so.
He was...
I miss the Millennium items. I know that Yugi got them all and put them away, but it'd be cool if they came back.
I really want Atem to come back, too. I mean, he...
I think he comes back in Dark Side of Dimensions. I have to go see that.
From what I've heard from a few friends and people that have seen it, Atem does come back, I think, in like a few scenes or something. Don't spoil anything, guys. We haven't seen the movie yet, so no spoilers if you have seen it.
Spoil it, you die.
Yes. TDS will come over to your house and...
seriously, I will send you to the Shadow Realm.
I will use Exodia and obliterate you.
Don't tempt me. I will use the mystical power of WoW Warrior to send you to the Shadow Realm.
WoW Warrior, that's your first choice.
Hey, he's my buddy.
Oh boy. Hey guys, here's a piece of advice, even aside from what we're talking about with the the most powerful Yu-Gi-Oh! Monster that I've ever seen is definitely Pikachu. You guys remember Pikachu, right? He was from the very beginning of the game. He came from Vestroia. Yeah, he was summoned he was summoned in Vestroia, and he came over.
You're killing fandoms here.
But you guys remember him, right? I mean,
fandoms are dying in Florida because of you.
Well, you know what? The fandoms in Florida can do with it. Everyone has heard of the legendary Pikachu. He came from Vestroia, who says, Beyblade, let it rip as, like, his attack. And he fights against those Digimon characters.
No, you don't understand. You don't understand. He uses the cards like spinning tops. He puts them in, and he spins them out, and they slice things and get paper cuts.
Paper cuts is the whole point of the freaking game. The winner is
paper cuts. You gave me a splinter.
Infinite paper cuts. That's how you win the game, guys. As many paper cuts as you can.
No, the person with the biggest deck wins because you have more cards, you have more ammo.
Oh, well, in that case, you know what? I can just picture it now.
I don't know what this card is, but here, let it rip.
I mean, if you really want to let it rip, go to, like, a taco place or something. I mean, you don't even have to bother with the cards.
Oh, don't.
No, seriously, guys, don't do that. You'll probably get kicked out of your own house for that.
But seriously, if you're in Vestroia, you should look up the Pikachu, because he's really powerful.
Yes, he is. He's more powerful than Exodia himself, and, you know, that's saying something.
Like, the Pokemon Mew, you know, Mew? Nothing compared to Pikachu.
You guys remember Mew? He was that guy from Legend of Zelda. He was that legendary swordsman that everyone kept mistaking for a guy and a girl. No one could tell the difference.
Error 404. Link not found.
Nope. they couldn't find the right link to connect to the game to find the answer. No pun intended.
Okay, yeah, guys. If you honestly are writing in the comments that how stupid we are, we're joking.
Yes, it's clearly a joke. Pikachu isn't from Yu-Gi-Oh! Pikachu is clearly from Bakugan.
Yu-Gi-Mons, of course. Duh.
Well, yeah, Pikachu's from Bakugan, not Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah, he's from Yugi-Mans.
Yugi-Mans. No, but really, guys, we know what we're talking
Yugi-Mans,
about.
Yugi-Mans, gotta catch them all.
Now, I bet you someone's going to make a remix video out of that. Actually, if someone ever decides to make a remix video of that, send it to me, because I would love to see that.
I bet you there is one somewhere.
Probably. This is freaking YouTube.
So many things on the internet now.
Everything's on this freaking website. Who are we kidding?
Yeah, and there's this whole thing now with 1,000-degree knives and slicing things.
No.
I don't get why you guys into. What are you guys doing with your lives?
Seriously. I mean, the trend Mr. Gear found on the internet was clearly the Holy Grail for a while. I don't know why.
Yeah, according to some research by another YouTuber, I guess you could call him that. Apparently, Mr. Gear didn't steal them.
Apparently, because I think it was a news channel on YouTube. He reported that Mr. Gear. It was alleged that he stole his 1,000-degree knife content from a smaller YouTuber, but it was discovered that
the smaller YouTuber changed the name.
Yeah, he changed the titles, like, right after the news report came out, and then everyone realized that, you know, oh, he didn't steal the content, so, yeah. But even if he didn't steal the content, I could make a 1,000-degree knife video. Anyone can do it.
And, yeah, the clickbait.
The clickbait, yeah.
Do you hear what's going on with Jacksepticeye right now? I feel so bad for the
See,
guy.
I feel bad. The whole PewDiePie drama video, yeah, I watched a news report on it.
You see Keemstar put out a video how Jacksepticeye backstabs PewDiePie.
Okay, guys, I am sorry I have to say this. I hate Keemstar just based off of everything that's happened with him. I normally don't give out my drama opinions, but I don't like him at all. He's a terrible person.
I hate him too. I am subscribed to him, and the only reason I am is so I can A, dislike his videos, and B, he does have the news, and I do learn things. So.
I'm subscribed to Scarce. I watch him, and I've never been subscribed.
I don't like Scarce either.
I've never been subscribed to Drama Alert, though.
I'm not subscribed in the sense where I watch every video. Like, I saw the one about Jacksepticeye, and I'm just like, Keem, I hate you. Bye.
Yep. Exactly. frankly, Jack doesn't deserve a lot of the criticism he's been getting. He realized that
He didn't mean to say it like that.
No.
Think about it. Go back and watch his video, you know, about when he roasted Felix, when he roasted him back. You know, they're friends. They would not be backstabbing each other.
Exactly. I mean, like, Jack, Mark, Pudes, they're all really good friends on YouTube. You know, Jack was just making the video to address all the points. I mean, he made a lot of really good points in the video.
He used it against
him. Yeah, and people like Keemstar and other fans, they thought that he was deliberately attacking him. I mean, true, he critiqued PewDiePie a little bit in the video, but overall, he was actually defending his friend, and he even pointed out the things wrong with the Wall Street Journal. And even afterwards, though, he tweeted out saying he talked to PewDiePie, and that, you know, he realized that he should have been more supportive of his friend. So even if there was some error in his video that he made, he's still trying to correct it. And it's not fair that...
And also, if you look in his video, if you go there now and look in the comment section, he pinned a comment up there where he talks more about it and says how he kind of made a mistake with the video. I personally think that Jack should send out another video, but I think it would be
misinformed
now.
Yeah,
based upon
people would probably take it out of context again, and you know.
Wait,
again,
were we talking about Yu-Gi-Oh before?
Yeah, we were. I don't know what happened. We started talking about drama channels, PewDiePie, Jacksepticeye, Pikachu from Bakugan. I mean, where's this podcast
no,
gone?
No, here, I suddenly got this. Yugioh equals Keemstar, because they're both Cancer.
Oh, well, what do you know?
That makes perfect sense.
This is the moment where the da-da, or the light comes on in everyone's minds. Like, yeah, that's right. I mean, geez.
Keemstar, I choose you. No, wait, I don't want
him. Wild Beardo has appeared. No, Gnome Star has appeared.
Wild Keemstar has appeared. Use a Pokeball? No, throw a rock.
I would rather just... No, it's Gnome Star. It's Gnome Star. Remember?
I think someone made a mod in Don't Starve Together that gives you the gnome staff.
I bet you someone did. There's all sorts of
stuff. Shoot gnomes out of the staff.
This podcast has just been so freaking random. I mean, we were talking about this new rule, and now we're talking about all this other stuff.
You see what this is? It's just more thing. Oh my gosh. I just got it.
What? Tell me.
Oh my god. I just realized the truth.
What's the truth?
Konami is Keemstar.
Oh no. You heard it here, guys. Drama alert is Yu-Gi-Oh.
That explains all the small text where it says support, enter code Keem for G Fuel. Yu-Gi-Oh G G Fuel?
Boo. No. I love that series. Oh, now I hate it.
We're so weird.
I know. We've been so...
I hate Aiden and his perfect hair.
Yes. Yes. You know what else I hate about Yu-Gi-Oh GX?
Everything?
Well, no. I don't hate everything about Yu-Gi-Oh GX, but the one thing that I do hate is that one card that they had in there that I really didn't like that they showed for the first time. I didn't like that much.
I don't know what that card is, but you know what I didn't like?
What?
There was an episode they went and visited Yugi's hometown.
And then Solomon...
Yeah, they went to the card.
What was
it? Saw Solomon Moto. He has Alzheimer's and he can't remember anything.
It was, is it where he said Yugi was probably off another adventure because he went like 5 years ago to go to a fruit stand.
Yeah. And he was like completely not there, and it was just like so sad.
Yeah, it was. Unfortunately, I mean. Exactly. And actually, now that I think about it, the one card I was referencing, by the way, was Cthulhu Pikachu. They came out with like at the beginning of the series, Cthulhu Pikachu.
Oh, yeah.
You remember that, right? The card Yugi handed Jaden at the beginning of the series? Cthulhu Pikachu?
Yeah, I know. It was Pikachu with wings, right?
Yeah, I think it was. He had, like, a jetpack on his back. He had, like, a big scruffy beard.
He was smoking a blunt.
Yeah, he was smoking a blunt. He had, baggy pants on with gold chains. He was holding a poster that said, subscribe to DeBoss Gaming.
Crossed out and it said subscribe to TDS
because
he's cool.
No, and then he finally settled and put subscribe to both the boss and master of the TDS at the bottom.
Yes, because we're random.
Yes. This whole conversation. And yes,
Sethuno Pikachu is not a real card.
No, it's not. Clearly, if any of you guys actually believed any of that, you don't know the game at all. Or
If you believed any of that, please go pick up your phone, dial 911, and say, I'd like to be committed, please.
If you believed any of that, please go throw your coffee out the window, throw your blunt in Goof's basement, because that's where he keeps all his sugar at. And that is a long story from a group chat we were talking about earlier today. Very long story.
I don't
You probably don't. Goof, if you're watching this.
All I know is that Goof's racist as a Canadian.
Oh my. What is this podcast turning into?
I haven't recorded proof of it. Alright, this became completely random. I think we're both just tired.
I think so. But at the same time, that was fun.
If you stuck with us for this long, guys, thanks.
Yes, thanks for
the randomness.
Because this video is almost at the 31-minute mark, so for everyone who watched this long and, you know, listened to everything we had to say on the new rule and all the random stuff that we talked about.
Cthulhu Pikachu.
Yeah, Cthulhu Pikachu.
Don't forget that.
Hey, if you guys watched this far in the video, put Cthulhu Pikachu in the comments. Then you'll know.
Cthulhu Pikachu! He shall avenge us and save us from Konami, aka Keemstar.
Put Cthulhu Pikachu or Keemstar is Konami in the comments.
Keemnami confirmed.
Yep, Keemnami confirmed. Put one of those two things in the comments just so we know if you watch this far.
No, it's like Keemnami, ha!
And then don't even get me started on adding Dragon Ball Z in here.
Oh my god, that was so bad.
Oh.
I'm sorry, guys. That was killing fandoms everywhere. Fandoms just died because of me.
You think I killed fandoms in Florida? You just killed, fandoms in Africa, Canada, California.
Oh, no, not Africa.
Antarctica.
He's there.
Yeah. The terrible thing is, kids in Africa could have eaten those Yu-Gi-Oh cards, and you just destroyed them. Oh, wow.
That's Harambe.
Yeah, that was... do not even bring that up. No. No.
All right, guys. We should close off. Basically, the point being is the game is going to change. It will. But it can change for the good, or it can change for the bad, it can change for the worse. But I think that's not up to Konami to decide. It's up to us. And I think if we all band together as a community and work together to learn this new mechanic and work together, we can make a better community than we even had before. But if we continue the way things are, then yeah, rip Yu-Gi-Oh! Because it's already gone.
Exactly, guys. And again, just as a final message, just to reiterate everything, it's not the end of the game. There's no point, you guys, for those of you who are thinking about quitting and you love the game, it's not the end of the world. You shouldn't do that. Keep an open mind, even if you may not like the rules, and I'm not saying you have to like them, because you may not, but use it as an opportunity to maybe, get together in the community and maybe help unite it, or at the very least, just adapt to it.